every lifetime comes to love like this. Oh, I need you, you need me. Oh, my darling, can't you see? Young ones, darling, we're the young ones. We're young ones.
Shouldn't be afraid
to live, love. There's a song to be sung. Cause we may not be the young ones very long.
Will you stop making that revolting noise, Vivian? You know I'm ill. You're only doing it to make me feel worse.
You're ill. I'm the one who's ill. Listen. Nobody feels any worse than me. And your shouting's not helping at all, Rick.
Oh, stop whining, Neil! You're practically brain dead as it is! Your dancing little pathetic little cold's gonna make much difference! You're probably not even ill anyway! You're probably just lying to try and impress us!
Oh, yeah? Well, how come I'm all hot and sweaty then?
I think most of us would rather not go into that! Will you two shut up! I'm trying to be ill! Oh, God! There's nothing left to wipe my nose on. Even that sweet cheese all covered in snot.
Too true.
Vivian, will you shut up? You're giving me tunnel vision.
Stop shouting, Neil!
Stop shouting yourself!
I am not shouting!
Yes, you are!
I'm bloody well, I'm not! If you want to hear shouting, matey, this is it!
It's funny, but being ill makes me lose my usual tolerant and easygoing approach to communal living.
Oh, well, how ruddy considerate, Vivian. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks, Viv. That petrol bomb's really cleared my sinuses.
Why are you dead? I'm not prepared to discuss it with you, Vivian. You'll be hearing from my solicitors in the morning. I've got to write to my MP.
But you haven't got an MP, Rick. You're an anarchist.
Well, then I shall write to the lead singer of Echo and the Bunnymen.
What's this?
It's a fish, Mike.
Oh, thanks.
Dear Mr. Echo.
Why did I do that?
Oh, Vivian, beginning to regret it now, are you?
Of course I'm beginning to regret it. That was nearly a full bottle of vodka. That's $7.99, you and me, ploppy pants.
Oh, stop being so blinking bored, Joyzy. All property is theft, Vivian.
All right, then. Where's your girly purse?
Wait a minute, I haven't finished my sentence. I meant to say, what's this fish doing in my bed?
It's not in your bed, Mike.
Oh, yeah, right, yeah, thanks, Vivian.
Found it!
You put that back! That's my personal property!
You just said all property's theft, Rick.
Well, yes, it is.
Yeah, but... so I'm nicking it.
Stop! Thief!
Thieves rush in where angels fear to tread.
No, it's fools, Neil. Oh. Fools.
Thieves rush in where fools fear to tread.
And Andy Williams said that!
Alexander Pope!
Oh, well, you're a little snob, aren't you, Vivian?
Wimp! Pervert! Nubbend!
Oh, Vivian! What repartee! Sticks and stones may break my bones!
That is the first sensible thing you have said all day!
Okay, so I've got it now. So what's this fish doing in my bed?
What fish?
Sorry. That's okay, mate. Just one more thing.
Shoot!
Anyone got a tissue?
Stop it, Neil!
I can't stop it.
Shoot! Quick, Vivian! The pillowcase!
That's so hard, Terry! Stick his head out the window! Oops!
Excuse me, did you throw that?
Yeah, good shot, wasn't it?
That's a bit extreme, isn't it? Won't he suffocate in there?
Very probably, Michael. But we've got to keep the bogies off the wall.
Yeah. Oh, wow. It's really horrible in here. Why did you have to use Rick's laundry bag?
Well, there's gratitude for you. It's me who's going to have to be wearing snotty undies for the next 2 turns, Neil. It's me they're going to be calling Bogey Bum. Especially at the next Friends of Starling Society Show Your Bottom competition.
I'm afraid I couldn't find any needles, Neil. So we'll have to use 6-inch nails.
Vivian, you can't do acupuncture with 6-inch nails.
Well, you better think of something quickly, because this bag's getting really full.
I'm going to the chemist.
Oh, great. What, to get some medicine for our colds?
No, I fancy the girl who works there.
Mike, in that case, do you think you could get something while you're there to clean the toilet with?
What?
I don't think I can, Neil.
You can't clean the toilet, Neil. It'll lose all its character.
We never clean the toilet, Neil. That's what being a student is all about. No way, Harpic. No way, Dot. All that blue loo scene is for squares. One thing's for sure, Neil. When Cliff Richard wrote Wired for Sound, no way was he sitting on a clean lavatory. He was living on the limit, just like me. We're the only place to put bleaches in your hair.
Living on limits? What, you want a diet?
Now I live on the limit, Vivian, the limit. Because I'm a writer at the gates of dawn and I take no prisoners.
I don't know what Neil's on about. That's cannibalism. I better get some domestos.
What's domestos?
Exactly this type of communal street life that the high-rise block is destroying.
Father wears his Sunday best. Mother's tired, she needs a rest. The kids are playing up downstairs. Sister's sighing in her sleep. Brother's got a date to keep, he can't hang around. Our house, in the middle of our street. Our house, in the middle of our...
I am now going to insert my first nail. Now, you might feel a bit of a prick.
So what's new?
Right, here goes.
Then she sends the kids to school. She's the one with the small kids. She's the one they're going to listen up to play.
£180 worth of Durex, please. Oh, sorry, force of habit.
My courage back with the cure.
Now, Neil, it's madness this week.
Sunday best. Mother's tired, she needs a rest. The kids are playing up downstairs. Sister's sighing in her sleep. Brother's got a date to keep, he can't hang around.
I'll pick you up at 8, okay?
Our house, in the middle of our street. Our house, in the middle of our street.
Mr. Damage to you, copper. And nobody tells Mr. Damage to shut his mouth, not if they want to keep their head in the vicinity of the shoulders. All right.
Listen. Shut your mouth, Damage.
Oh, God, we've got to do something before this bag explodes.
Hey, brilliant idea. Maybe sneezing's like hiccups, and you have to give him a frightful shock to make them go away.
I think he'll get a shock when he feels this. We've run out of nails, so we'll have to start using the cutlery.
No, be sensible. I've got to eat off that.
I suppose you're right.
My brain's exploded! My brain's exploded!
Didn't work.
Not surprised, Vivian. It was pathetic. Let's do something more subtle.
Okay. Nil, if you don't stop sneezing by the time I count three, I'm going to cut your bottoms off and run them up your nose, okay? One. That's it.
Oh, well. I wish this wasn't happening to me.
Hurry up. My usual table for two, 8:30.
2.999 recurring. Right, do it.
And nothing will happen. Goodness, how exciting. Are you an anarchist?
No, I am not. I am Brian Damage Bolofsky. I am, however, a violent and highly dangerous escaped criminal madman.
What would you like us to do?
Right, everybody up against this wall.
Now! He says nobody move and nothing will happen. How are we going to get to the wall if we can't move?
And more to the point, what happens if we do move to the wall?
Hey. Oh, God, look, what happens if anybody moves?
What happens?
Yes!
Oh, right, I'm terribly sorry, terribly sorry. Right. Now, if anybody moves, right, I'll show you what happens, right? This happens, right?
Oh, hi, man, are you the doctor? Hey, I think that's done the trick. Thanks, Doc.
Thanks, Doc. Are you being sarcastic or something, my son? That's one of my least favourite things that happens to be. Sarcasm.
Lily. How incredibly interesting.
I was walking the dog, right? And this bloke, he comes up to me and he says, nice day, innit? But it wasn't. It wasn't a nice day. It was a little bit cloudy, which makes him very sarcastic. So acting as if nothing could happen, right? I got his head, right? I stuck it in my mouth, right? Acting dead casual-like. I closed my teeth, right? And bit his head off! I say, I hate people being sarcastic.
Yeah, well, I wasn't, being sarcastic.
Winger? Yeah. Oh, forget everything I just said then, all right?
Everything from when you first came in.
Now, if you don't get up against that wall, by the time I count three, I'm going to blow your heads off one by one, all right? I won. Action! Oh, God!
Sorry, not love. Some joker's impaled a head on the front door. Hello, Vivian?
Piss off!
That's no way to talk to your mother, Vivian.
All right, then. Piss off, Mum!
That's better.
What do you want?
Well, what are mums for?
I don't know, having babies?
Don't be so sexist, Vivian.
I'm sorry, Mum.
No, I heard you was ill, so I brought you a present.
Last present you gave me was a box of matches.
That was a joke.
I was only 8 weeks old.
Here, excuse me. I'm not actually known for my patience.
Oh, well, you're probably not Dr. Kildare, then.
Well, what have you brought me this time?
A bottle of vodka.
Oh, brilliant. Thanks, Mum. This is empty.
Ha-ha, up yours, ugly.
Cool, what a nasty woman. All right, this has now gone on far too seriously long enough by half, okay? I am now going to phone the authorities, right? And if they do not give me, within 20 minutes, a helicopter, £100,000, a complete set of steak knives in a presentation box, 7 tickets to see the Brazilian National Mime Theatre at the Riverside Studios, a little cairn terrier called Bobby, one of them little black rubber things, the ones that go nick, 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 nick. Yeah, big box full of them, right? The complete memoirs of Donald Sinden.
Very handy!
Otherwise, I'm going to blow your heads off, all right? Now, everybody, up against that wall, now!
All right. Oh, no! Lummy! All right, who's responsible?
Well, I think I'm quite responsible, actually.
Yeah, Mike is, yeah.
Listen! Somebody has got to clear all this muck up! And I can tell you one thing, matey boy, it's not going to be me.
What does a villain must matter? We're all going to be dead in 20 minutes anyway!
Yeah. Oh, no! Oh, well! Oh, heavy, heavy, heavy!
Oh. What are you upset for? You've always wanted to die.
Who's talking about dying? I just remembered. My parents are coming round to tea.
Don't panic. Worst things happen at sea.
Like what, Mike? Like what?
All right, you could be on a nice cruise in the South China Seas, having a lovely time. There's terrible weather, a big storm, and the ship sinks. You fall overboard, you're drowning. This big shark swims up to you, opens his mouth, he says, by the way, Neil's parents are coming to tea in 30 seconds. That's when you panic. Yeah. Come on.
All hail, McVivian, Thane of Corridor!
Aye?
All hail, McVivian, Thane of the outside toilet, and that little gravelly patch next to the garden shed.
All hail, McVivian, that shall be king of the whole house hereafter!
Are you suggesting that I murder Mike, Rick, and Neil in order to have the whole house to myself?
Yeah!
It's a thought, I suppose. Make a great play!
27, 28, 29.
Look out!
Hello, Mummy. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Take my coat, please. Come in. This is my house where I live. These are my friends. This is Rick. He's studying sociology.
Oh, hello. Pleased to meet you. So many essays to write. I'm surprised my arms aren't falling off. Perhaps they are. Look out. Boom. You have to look out for me because I'm a bit nutty. Aren't I, everybody? A bit nutty.
Hello.
Oh, and this is Mike. He's studying...
Well, I'm in what you'd call the School of Life, Mrs. Pye.
Oh! Oh, dear, Neil, what a ghastly smell.
Yeah, that's Vivian, Mummy. He's going to be a doctor.
How do you do?
Fascinating. I think I'm going to be sick.
Is this fellow another of your colleagues?
Oh, no, that's the most violent and highly dangerous.
That's Neil's little joke, sir. Brian Damage are currently working on my PhD in astrophysics, actually. recently I did work on a degree in art history, but it was no use for a job, you know.
What kind of a job had you in mind?
Oh, something like a bank job, you know.
Nice safe job.
Yeah, possibly.
Did you make your bed?
No, I bought it.
Exactly.
Now, your mother and I are very disappointed by all this, Neil.
You have brought shame on your family, Neil. I don't show my face at Lady Fanshawe's bridge evenings, now that you've taken up with those television people. I mean, what sort of monsters are you? I mean, the young ones. Well, it all sounds very good, doesn't it? But just look around you. It's trash! I mean, even Triangle has better furniture than you do.
I think you'll find that was specially designed to fall apart like that, Mrs. Pye. Rick was going to get hit over the head with it in the next scene.
I thought you'd be like, glad, you know, that I was doing something worthwhile.
Worthwhile? I mean, it's a bloody outrage. It's a waste of a licensing fee. Oh, pardon my French. Well, why can't you be in one of those decent situation comedies that your mother likes? What's the thing called?
Plain Chill!
That's the one.
So that's settled then. We organise a protest against school uniforms.
Right. We can use the banners left over from the last protest we organised so that racism wouldn't be an issue in this school.
Good. Then that's what we'll do. I'll get Macca, Tracker, Ducker and Sucker. You get Spaz.
But I am Spaz.
Oh, well, I better get Spaz as well then. But we've got to hurry. Oh!
Sorry, Mr. Liberal. We were in a hurry.
Hang on, you pair of young scruffy tearaways. Don't you realise the way you act is influencing millions of children to talk Cockney and be insubordinate? Oh, come on, sir, don't be silly. We're the only kids in Britain who never saved
you. You must be talking nonsense. I don't watch that ghastly programme.
No, I'm sorry, my dear. It was my mistake. I meant The Good Life.
Oh, yes, that's the one.
No! Oh, I'm not watching The Bloody Good Life! Bloody! I hate it! It's so bloody nice! Felicity Treacle Kendall and Richard Sugar-Flavored Snob Briars! What do they do now?
chocolate bloody butternuts, that's what! They're nothing but a couple of reactionary stereotypes confirming the myth that everyone in Britain is a lovable, middle-class eccentric, and I hate them!
That was a highly articulate outburst, Vivian. I only hope they're not watching.
Well, you can just shut up, Vivian. You can just about blooming well shut up! Because if you've got anything horrid to say about Felicity Kendall, you can just about blooming well say it to me first, all right? Rick, I just did. Oh, you did you? Well, I've got a good mind to give you a bloody good punch on the bottom for what you just said. You're talking about the woman I love.
Yeah, and me, I love her too.
Yes, well, I agree with the spotted twerps on that one. Felicity Kendall is sweetly pretty. Just what a real girl should be. I mean, speaking as a feminist myself, I can safely say this. That Felicity Kendall is a wonderful woman, and I want to protect her.
Well, it's the first time I've ever heard it called that.
Say something.
Shut up, Vivian, that's my dad you're talking.
Did you see that episode where the pig was going to have a baby? Now, that was quite a promising idea. But it was all done so bloody nicely! We didn't see anything! Even the policeman was nice!
All right, why shouldn't the police people treat us nice occasionally? You trendy students always giving us a bad name.
Well, you mean like big jobbies?
Oh, right, now you've really asked for it. Well, let me assure you, I would not have done that to you if you'd been Felicity Kendall. God, are you all right?
Was that silly, Cassie? Smashed the special balsa wood chair earlier on.
Well, none of this would have happened if you'd been doing a nice program like The Good Life.
Right, that's where we'll put the row cabbages. Okie dokie, Mikey. Young Sonny Jim, follow me, lad.
And that's where we'll put the row of collies.
Aha! Uh-huh. Just wait one moment, Michael.
Very funny, Vivian.
Laugh, Michael. It's on the ages to raise
the
pets up and
lay
them off
the timeless wonder of the English countryside. Good grief, Christine. It'd be pretty bloody super to have a snog in a place like this. What do you think, Bill?
Well, I don't feel like it, actually, really. I've got a lot of work to do.
Not with you, you sick pervy. I meant with a pretty bloody super girly who's on for an amazing bit of rumpo.
I've ploughed this bit, right? And now I'm going to sow it. This self-sufficiency thing really is amazing, you know, Rick. Like, we sow the seed, right? Nature grows the seed, and then we eat the seed. And then, after that, we sow the seed, nature grows the seed, and then we eat the seed. Right. And then after that, again, we sow the seed, nature grows...
Oh, shut up! Shut up! Shut up! It's pathetic! I mean, what about radical magazines? Hmm? What about kicker boots? Can we glue them? No, we can't, can we? The beauty of your plan, Neil, seems to rest on everybody being really into seeds.
No, Rick, you don't understand the timeless wonder of the whole thing. Right?
I don't.
We sow the seed. Nature grows the seed. Then we eat the seed. Then we...
Right, now shut up. Come on, get up, Neil. There's a lot of work to be done. Neil? Oh, God! Oh, God, I've killed a hippie! I've killed a hippie, and now I'll have to pay. Oh, God, Vivian's bound to tell on me, and I'll get sent to prison and raped in the shower by Mr. Big, who's in with the warders. Burn the corpse. Burn the corpse. Burn. Burn. God, trust Neil to be all soggy. Burn. Burn.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
My name's Mick. This is Tess.
All right, are you? Tess?
We would have bought Harry, but we don't know anyone called Harry.
Excuse me. You're not a policeman, are you?
No, we're not policemen.
Oh, sorry. Look, we've come about the muck. Muck?
Yeah, look, you know manure?
Yes.
We've been told to drop a load in your garden.
Well, listen, absolutely nobody, I don't care who they are, is doing a two-ton poo outside my front door.
So, just thought you might need it to cover up that dead hippie you just murdered, that's all.
Yeah. Yes, bury him. But it's not a hippie. It's just a garden gnome that I accidentally cracked.
What a load of old crap. It's not a gnome. It's a hippie he's just killed. He's just killed a hippie, everybody.
So this is the row of mixed veg. Oh, nicely. We progress. To grow anything, fertilizer has arrived.
Brilliant. We are now completely self-sufficient in fertiliser. Speaking of which, where's Neil?
Yeah, where is he? I specifically told him that if we don't sow the seed, nature can't grow the seed, and we can't eat the seed. Eh?
He's emigrated. And he said to say that you'll never see him again.
Well, he's left one of his shoes behind. He's left one of his feet behind as well.
Bloody idiot.
Yes! I noticed he was hopping when he left.
Hang on a minute, Rick. If you say...
Oh, no. Night time.
Grief. Oh, well. Boing.
Boing.
Time for bed, everyone.
Lucky Rick only stunned me, eh?
Oh, wow. Hello? Hello? Anybody watching that must have thought it was a negative reality inversion.
Cool, that looked just like a negative reality inversion, didn't it?
Yes, it did a bit.
I was right. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Oh, wow. Rick planted me. I was the seed. Rick sowed me. Nature grew me. Yeah.
Rick. Rick. This is the voice of your conscience speaking.
Shut up! Shut up!
Don't tell me to shut up, you spotty little bastard. I'm your conscience. You killed Neil, didn't you?
No, it wasn't me. It was Vivian and Mike. They did it, and I'm going to tell on them as well.
They didn't bloody well do it. It was you.
I've got whose side are you on?
Not bloody yours, matey.
Get out of my head, poo hole.
Try and make me, farty breath.
Rick, will you tell your conscience to keep its voice down? I'm trying to get some sleep.
Oh, come on, Judge Mike. He's obviously a complete bastard. Let's hang him.
But I'm the people's poet, the spokesperson of a generation. Kids everywhere look to me for inspiration.
Oh, people's poet, don't die. We'll kill ourselves if you do. But first, we're going to take off all our clothes.
Oi, stop having a wet dream, you little pervy. You're supposed to be racked with remorse.
I am.
Neil! Owen's Bill! If only I could see you again!
Hello, Rick. Hello, Rick. Hello, Rick.
Help! Michael! Vivian! Neil's come back from the grave as zombies!
Yeah. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Night's Time with Neil's parents and Brian Damage. We'll be right back.